Hey, Kat Matlock here for FreeBody. And in this video, I'm going to introduce you to the iliacus muscle. And then I'm going to show you how to release it yourself in two ways, one sitting in a chair and then one down on the floor. So the iliacus muscle is the lesser known portion of the iliopsoas. It's the ilio part of the iliopsoas. So it's very famous partner. The psoas muscle gets a lot of attention and a lot of talk and a lot of study. But iliacus kind of doesn't get as much play. And I think that this is a shame because the iliacus is a very key muscle to shifting all different kinds of tensional patterns and dysfunction in the body. It can be affect knee problems, hip problems, low back issues. So let's talk about why. Okay, so the iliacus lines the inside of the pelvis. On either side of the pelvis, lining the inside is the iliacus muscle. Then it comes down through the groin and becomes a kind of conjoined twin with the psoas. The psoas comes from along the spine. Iliacus comes from inside the pelvis. And then the two of them dive deep. It's actually more toward the very front, dive deep into the femur, to the back of the femur. Iliacus and the psoas are both hip flexors, whereas the psoas pulls the spine and the thigh toward each other. Iliacus pulls the pelvis and the thigh toward each other. So this muscle gets really out of whack anytime the psoas is unhappy, anytime the hip flexors are unhappy, anytime the hip extensors, which are gluteus maximus and hamstrings, when they're unhappy. It doesn't like it when you sit for long periods of time, especially if you sit in a tuck and you're tucking your pelvis under, that pulls strongly on that iliacus muscle. And it also gets dysfunctional if you have a hyperlordosis, a little too much. It can get really strained in pregnancy when your belly is drawing you more in a tilt than in a tuck, and that might be shifting really big tensional systems in your body. Iliacus pain can feel like pelvic pain, and it can also radiate down the front of the thigh. So it can be pelvic pain, radiate down the front of the thigh, and it's always a player in back pain. So iliacus, such a key muscle. I'm so excited that you're here to learn this release. The first thing you have to do is feel where your iliacus is. You have to be able to feel your pelvis. So bring your hands to the soft side of your waist and then find the top edges of your pelvis, these pelvic rims. They're called the iliums, right? Each one is an ilium. So iliacus lining the inside of the ilium. At the very front of the pelvis, you can find two hip points, the ASIS, or anterior superior iliac spine. ASIS is on the front points of the pelvis. Now the pelvis goes from there and then starts to come up and curl back and around. So our best access to the iliacus is just behind that very front point. And you have to kind of get up into the soft part of your waist to get into it. And sometimes bowing forward and softening your belly will give you a little bit more play, a little bit more play in the tissue so that you can actually get your thumbs in there. And the idea, I'm gonna scoot up, the idea is that you can get your thumbs inside and hook out toward the rim of the pelvis. So I sink into my belly, push out toward the rim of my pelvis. You wanna really picture that muscle and hook in. So see, I keep kind of collapsing a little bit so that I soften that tissue so I can get my thumbs right in there. Oh, such a tender spot. And then a little tilt and tuck of the pelvis. Do a little tilt and tuck of the pelvis. I'm gonna move my fingers away so you can see where those thumbs are. And I'm pushing right against the outside rim of my pelvis. Ah, just release. Ah, so good. Ah, phew. Yeah, feels so much better. So you do that same thing on the other side, find that front point of the pelvis, walk back a little bit, soften the front of your body so that you have some play in the tissue, sink your thumbs in, and then hook them outward, out toward the outside of the hip, so that you're just trapping that tissue right in there. My thumb is right in a terrible spot right now. It's tender. Right? It's not terrible. It's working hard. So now I'm going to tilt and tuck little bit. And that tilt engages the iliacus and the tuck pulls it along. And then after a little while, I feel that changing. I feel that shifting. So much better. Great. So that's the main points in iliacus. There are sometimes some way in the back you could keep kind of just finding along. Usually I find another one all the way back in the back of the pelvis. It's a bit harder to get into yourself. What I find is that if you release those front points, often the tension in the iliacus will go down so much, and really you'll feel such a difference. Knees, hips, back. So now that you've learned how to do it in a chair, I'm gonna get down on the floor and I'm gonna show you how to release this muscle on the floor. Okay, so now we're on the floor. You're gonna lay on your back with your knees bent and your feet on the floor. So get into that position so that your belly tissue is soft. If you straighten the legs out, it might be pulling on that iliacus, and that's not what you want, right? So you want the belly to be a little soft. So here, I find that front point of my pelvis again, and I'm gonna slide, I'm gonna walk it up. See, I can feel I'm walking along this rim of the pelvis, the ilium, and knowing that iliacus lines that inside of the pelvis. So I wanna get my fingers or my thumbs in the soft tissue of my belly and sink down toward the floor and then push it wide. So I'm pushing those thumbs out toward my outer hip. Oh, and there it is again. Oh, so much better. It's already released because I just released it, right? So tilt and tuck. It doesn't have to be the worst thing you've ever felt, right? Let it be a little gentle. You don't have to push really hard, just a little bit, enough that it feels special, that it feels like a special spot, right? Oh, there it goes. Great. Super good. I'm going to tilt and tuck a couple times. That left side feels so much better than the right already. So again, I'm going to come over to the right side and hook down in, and I'm going to roll towards you a little bit so you can see. Even this position would work, laying on your side so that that belly and that hip is really soft. And then you can slide your thumbs in there and pushing toward that outside, trapping the iliacus muscle there. So take a couple breaths and tilt and tuck the pelvis. You can stay laying on your back, or you could do this kind of half roll to your side. Works great too. Okay, great. And then you just kind of explore along that inside. See how my thumbs are going toward the inside of my pelvis, just following that pelvic rim. Great. Then you want to roll back onto your back if you moved, and tilt and tuck the pelvis a couple times. You can hug your knees in towards your chest or towards your shoulders. Let them get really soft. And then feet come back to the floor. And that's it. Thanks for being here. I'm Kat Matlock with FreeBody. We just released our iliacus. You can check out a bunch of other videos on the channel. Please subscribe to the channel. Hit the little bell so that you get notifications when I'm releasing new videos. And I look forward to seeing you again soon.